Difficult times, we do as we must. We find time to reflect on anything that we can do to better or prevent, mitigate effects of a tragedy of any kind. We remember with sadness the most devastating natural disaster in the country's recorded history, which is Cyclone Idai. The destruction was beyond our wildest imagination, as we could not have foretold the magnitude of the cyclone. We saw water-defying mountains resulting in loss of life and significant damage to infrastructure, to crops, and to livestock. As we reflect on the cyclone, however, Zuva Petroleum cannot but marvel at the strength and dignity of human life in the face of such overwhelming disaster. Indeed, the cyclone has neither robbed the people of Zimbabwe of their spirit nor of their dignity. It can never be the same without education. Education is a dream that you hold in your hand, dreams that you can pursue, dreams that can make you more successful, open-minded, stronger, and a better people. So today we are not only donating furniture, today we are donating dreams. I'd like to take this opportunity to express our gratitude to all the schools that have come to be part of this occasion, and all the ministries, the government ministries that are represented here this morning. Thank you.
And one of the fundamental functions that we have as a ministry is to ensure that we have access to education for anybody who needs it, and I believe anybody, because now we have another facet that has not been quite known, the non-formal sector, where we can allow even those much older than me to come and learn the new things in the school. We also have the ordinary schools that you are aware of. And so we have access that we give to everyone else. And above that, we are charged with making sure that we bring quality products. So whoever comes must then be ensured that they must be receiving quality education. And to that effect, when the cyclone came, it did affect us in two ways. First, we lost some of the learners, and we are really sorry about it. And secondly, infrastructure and learning materials were destroyed. And this infrastructure goes as far as the classrooms and the furniture inside. And so we have not been able to really to keep pace with the development of these things. And we are saying when Zuva comes in, they do help us to achieve our strategic goal of quality education, because in these schools, we welcomed them very much, and we want to profusely extend our sincere thanks to Zuva for bringing in this help. I know certain schools will say, but we are also affected. No, you see, when we receive a gift, we select, and in the process of selecting, I know everybody wants to be selected, but based on the criterion that we had, these were picked. And certain schools have to be aware that their chance will also come. So can I ask you to join hands as I extend my sincere thanks to Zuva.
Today is another day whereby we are actually bring afresh the memories that relates to the disaster that struck Zimbabwe, particularly Chimanimani and Chipinge. Those are basically the epicenters of the disasters. I may not want to chronicle a lot, but otherwise everyone knew what happened sometime last year. We are almost a year now, and we feel very sorry for the disaster, for our province, for our country, for our districts, for our people in Zimbabwe. There are quite a number of things that were affected. But otherwise, I just want to acknowledge the role that has been played, or that is being played by Zuva Petroleum in Manicaland. From the day that we experienced the cyclone Idai, apart from the government alone tackling the problem cyclone Idai, we found our dear good friends, the Zuva Petroleum, chipping in to complement the government effort in trying to store hope, lost hope among the people of Manicaland, among the people of Chimanimani and Chipinge. We found them at a very needing time to come and address that. We are quite grateful to Zuva for that intervention. I know at its peak, the Zuva chipped in with a lot of assistance in terms of fuel, in terms of transport, in terms of any other aid that was actually provided to the province. In May 2019, Zuva donated $100,000 to Ministry of Local Government and Public Works to help rebuild 5 schools. During the time of the cyclone, like, quite a number of infrastructure was destroyed. You talk of agriculture, you talk of schools being destroyed, you can talk of anything, the road, the mining sector, education sector, everything was destroyed. It never spared anyone. But otherwise, Zuva found it very prudent that they should come and chip in timelessly to give aid, to give assistance to the people of Manicaland. And at the same time, complement government effort in all so many ways. Again, they chipped in 2019, where in November 2008, a visit to the affected schools was done to leave behind a signage with the school's name and the Zuva logo. Zuva Cares is the brand that anchors the Zuva corporate social mission. As a corporate, they felt that the need to do more for the schools as part of the rehabilitation process to the cyclone Idai victims. In fact, all the underlying point is that they came in at an opportune time to give assistance in form of money, in form of fuel, to restore hope in the education sector. That's why today we are gathered here again. They have actually come in to say, no, what we did initially was not enough. Let us as well pull other resources to come to Manicaland, to give a donation to the people of Manicaland in the form of furniture, in the form of chairs. The idea is to restore hope in the education sector. Thankful indeed Mr. Shumba is here. I think that's a good news for you, so that the education sector, there's no reason as to why you would say next time to say, our children are seated under trees.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page 263chat.